Today, I will be simplifying the ankle joint, also known as the talo-crural joint. In this video, we are going to elaborate on the type of joint, its stabilizing factors, movements, innervation, and blood supply, and some interesting clinicals relating to the ankle joint. This is obviously a hinge-type joint. The articular surfaces that form this joint are the lower end of the tibia, including the medial malleolus, the lateral malleolus of the fibula, and the inferior transverse tibio-fibular ligament. These together form a sort of a deep socket that forms the upper articular surface. The lower articular surface is formed by the articular areas on the upper, medial, and lateral aspects of the talus. The stability of the joint is ensured by the close interlocking of articular surfaces, strong collateral ligaments, and the tendons that cross the joint. There are four tendons in front: Tibialis Anterior, Extensor Hallucis Longus, Extensor Hallucis Brevis, and Peroneus Tertius. Three tendons in the posterior medial aspect are Tibialis Posterior, Flexor Digitorum Longus, Flexor Hallucis Longus. Two on the posterolateral aspect are Peroneus Longus and Peroneus Brevis. Another factor that increases the stability of the joint is its depth and concavity of the upper articular surface. First and most apparent factor is the downward projection of medial and lateral malleoli. The other is the inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament that bridges between the tibia and the fibula behind the talus. The forward pull of the tendons and the weight of the foot when the heel is raised tend to displace the tibia and fibula anteriorly over the talus. This is prevented by the wedge shape of the talus. It is wider anteriorly so that the malleoli won't slip forward. The posterior border of the lower end of the tibia is prolonged downwards. The presence of the inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament that we discussed earlier also helps to prevent the forward displacement of the tibia and fibula over the talus. And also, parts of the medial and lateral collateral ligaments help in this stability. Let us talk a bit more in detail about the ligaments that are involved in stabilizing the ankle joint. The fibrous capsule, it surrounds the joint entirely, but it's relatively weak anteriorly and posteriorly. Since it's a synovial joint, the capsule is lined by synovial membrane. It's attached all around the articular margins, with two exceptions. Posteriorly, it is attached to the inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament, and antero-inferiorly, it is attached to the dorsum of the neck of talus at some distance away from the trochlear surface. The loose and thinness of the capsule anteriorly and posteriorly allows for a hinge movement. Let's move on to the collateral ligaments. Unlike the anterior and posterior aspects, the lateral and medial sides have to be highly enforced and immobile to restrict the joint to a hinge movement only. The medial ligament or the deltoid ligament. This is a triangular ligament and hence gives the name deltoid ligament. It's composed of three parts: anterior tibio-navicular fibers, which are attached to the tuberosity of the navicular bone and to the medial margin of the spring ligament. The middle or tibiocalcanean fibers are attached to the entire length of the sustanaculum tali. The posterior or posterior tibiotalar fibers are attached to the medial tubercle of posterior process of the talus. The deltoid ligament is crossed by tendons of tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus. I will upload another video on the layers of muscles in the sole of the foot. You'll see it appear on the top right corner. Alright, moving on to the lateral ligament. This ligament consists of three bands as follows: anterior talofibular ligament, posterior talofibular ligament, and calcaneofibular ligament. The movements allowed by the ankle joint are dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. This is not to be confused with the subtalar and talocalcaneonavicular joints that allow eversion and inversion of the foot. According to the Hilton's law, this joint is also supplied by the nerves that pass through it, which are deep peroneal and tibial nerves. And the blood supply is by the anterior tibial, posterior tibial, and talotibial arteries. Alright, and now for the interesting part, clinicals. Dislocations of the ankle joint are very rare, because the ankle joint is very stable due to all the factors I mentioned previously in the video. The lateral collateral ligament is far more frequently affected in ankle sprains because the medial collateral ligament is stronger and also because you are far more likely to forcibly invert your ankle rather than evert. You can test this on yourself. In an abduction external rotation injury of the ankle joint, a first, second or third degree Potts fracture may result. This video is getting too long for that, so I'll include more details of the Potts fracture in the description. For those of you who are interested, you can check it out. Alright, let's do a quick recap before we move on to the next part. I feel like I went over everything too quickly, so let's do the recap even faster. Joint type. This is a hinge type joint. Articular surfaces. You have upper and lower articular surfaces. Upper articular surfaces, lower tibia, medial malleolus, lateral malleolus, inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament. Lower has upper medial and lateral talus. Stabilizing factors. Tendons. Anteriorly, you have tibialis anterior, extensor hallucis longus, and brevis, and peroneus tertius. Posterior medial, we have tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, and hallucis longus. Posterolateral, you have peroneus longus and brevis. Ligaments, you have the deltoid ligament on the medial side and the lateral collateral ligament on the lateral side. The deltoid ligament has tibio-navicular fibres, tibiocalcanean fibres, and tibio-talar fibres. The lateral ligament consists of anterior talar fibular ligament, posterior talar fibular ligament, and calcaneo fibular ligament. And as for the interlocking articular surfaces, you have the lower ends of the tibia and fibula prolonged downwards, and the wedge shape of the talus, and the fibrous capsule that surrounds the joint entirely. Movements. Ankle joint only allows dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Remember, it does not involve eversion and inversion. And as always, thanks for watching. Be sure to click the like button and subscribe for more videos like this.